Oh, Joe got him. Joe got him. Come this side, Joe.
Yep.
Slab magnet?
Oh, yeah. Oh, look at that pig.
Yeah, man. Get that one in the boat, Joe. Ready? Ready?
Let's see if I can even lift this one.
Nope.
I'm going to go down there and scoop him up.
I think that's going to be a scooper.
Okay. Come on, Joe. Let's see.
Oh, that's yours. That is a slab. Look at the size of that, eh?
Here, that's yours.
Thank you. There we go.
That was the ticket right there, dude.
It was.
The bigger bait.
They just wanted that bigger profile and angered it, right?
Can you see how he came over and ate that thing,
oh,
dude?
Oh, yeah, just destroyed it. There was no mistaking this time, right?
But the single pole, picking it up and stalking them down one by one, is gotta be high on your list. Cause man, it is number one for me. I love fishing the float, finding fish, seeing that little bobber go down, reminiscent of being a kid again, you know, fishing for crappie or perch or rock bass or whatever it be. But man, when I pick up, especially this one right here, it's called the Sam Super Sensitive by B&M, 12 footer. I don't know what it is, man. It's just something about stalking them down, hunting them, looking for cover, reading the water, reading the bush, figuring out how high to hold it. Do I lower it? Do I jiggle it? Do I move it? Do I hold it still? All those little intangibles. You might think to yourself, wow, sounds kind of confusing. It's not. But it's all the parts you got to put together when you're picking up that single pole. And in this case, it's called a jig pole. And you are fishing that little jig. And in this case, it's the crappie magnet, slab magnet. That's a little bigger body, a little slayed tail, real flat and stuff. And see how easy it shakes and stuff with the 1/8 ounce, 1/16 little jig heads. And, you know, picking colors, I'm going to show you all that stuff after, but this is just about stocking them down, picking a day to just go out and go fishing. So right now, I'm going to do that. So let's see how, where, and when. The how, where, and when's real quickly are the 12-footer with the setback reel seat, okay? And that right here is the 01 little reel. All it does is just hold line. Like, there's no casting, there's no drifting, there's none of that. That just holds line. It's convenient. Once in a while, I loosen off the tension knob, pull a bit more line out so I can fish. And remember, with a 12-footer and 12 feet of line out, that's 24 feet of pendulum that I can work all around the boat when I put the power poles down and don't even move. Just fish. Other options, and you know it, man. I stick with the 12 footer, and that's the ultra light with the bottom reel seat again, right back there. Something about this, I just can't beat it, man. It's unreal, can't beat it. Again, with the little slab magnet. And last but not least, I got the 11 foot jig pole with the slab magnet again, setback reel seat, and this right here. The blank through the handle, I can't even tell you how important that is. And you say, okay, look at that little reel at the back. That is so important. It's out of the way. Sometimes you have a spinning reel that sits up here somewhere. You got that handle sticking out. You don't even use it anyway. The line, when you're playing around all a bit, back and forth, goes around there, you get a big fish, you lose it, you start cussing and stuff. You don't want to do that. These little reels, I think they cost like 20 bucks, 19 bucks, whatever it is, just holds the line for this kind of fishing. They're worth every single penny. Get those little reels right there. B&M, they have got them. All the stores, Grizzly Tackle, Grizzly Jig Company, all the big box stores. I'm not going to name them all. You know who I'm talking about. Go out there and find it. Look for the little B&M right there. The old one just holds a little bit of line. Doesn't cost much, but man, oh man. Does it make single poling so much more easier when you have the setback reel seat and all you have to worry about is just looking where you're going to put the bait and catch those crappie. Pretty shallow up here, but that doesn't mean nothing. That doesn't mean anything. I caught them up like in this stuff. I'd say, look at that one. Oh yeah. That's what we're looking for right there, boys. Just finished saying, I've been catching up in that shallow stuff too. Look at that. Look where we took the therapist, dudes. Easy now. Look where that is right there. Is that a typical crappy gulf? You're joining your six buddies, buddy. Yeah, you're joining them. See, skinny little bellies. They haven't done their business. They've done their business. They're just hanging around. They're just hanging around, you know? This is just unreal. This just goes to show you, really, you gotta move around. I'm fishing the best stuff right in this little cut, and it's only 3.9, not even 4 feet deep. And I was fishing the end, I caught the first couple fish. Some small fish, they're moving around a bit. I swung and put that bait because I got the 12 foot SAM super sensitive by B&M. That jig pole, again, see that? 12 feet, I'm a little bit shy. So I'll let a little bit line out like that, loosen it. I'll pull it down. And now, tighten up. There's 24 feet of pendulum all around the boat that I can fish. That fish showed me, get it up tight where we are, I'll lead it. Here's the deal with this. There's no sun. I can't see them. I can only have faith that I'm fishing in the right areas because I believe they're in the brush. Water temperatures show me 59.86. It doesn't want to go to 60. Incredible. Crappies don't care. They're trying to do their business around here. So I'm just fishing along. Duncan putting the pole down, man. Duncan holding it slow, lifting up. What I do is I swim it a bit, stop. A little bit of shake, and I stop. It's the stop that gets the bite. They see it moving and stuff. Unless they're real aggressive, they come and chase it and eat it. But those big fish, they come like this, they slow down, and then they eat it. That's the reason they get big. They're not the smartest creatures in the world, but man, they know it's opportunistic. They stop thinking that thing looks like a little emerald shiner or something, or a little perch. When it's in front of their face, done. Worlds. How about right here? Look at this one. Oh my goodness me. Look at those that are sitting in the nasty, huh? Tell me that's not a beautiful crappie. Look at this up close. I'm going to show you how the mermaid works right there. Look at that. Look at that. That's like 15-inch crappies, boys. Those are big crappies. Those are big. Now you know we're really hunting them down, right? Wow, in the meat, man. In the meat. Turn, pop out. Look at that, man. That's a big slab, boy. You know where he's going? In the good side. And then I let him go. Look at that mouth. When they inhale like that, it's gonzo. Let's put him inside, and then we'll let him go after some pictures, because I got some eating size ones. But I mean, when you fish slow and methodical, have color options, and I got three rods, the SAM super sensitive and two ultralights. One ultralight that's 11, one's 12, SAM super sensitive 12. And I got tied on a couple, three colors right here. Let me show you. Let me move my safety net out of the way here. I've got the therapist, which is purple chartreuse right there. Jig head, I gotta keep a chartreuse in this tea color water. I just have to. I wanna see it. Because if I see it, I know they see it. On the under ultralight, white with chartreuse, chartreuse head. And I picked up now the mermaid. With the chartreuse on the ultralight. You tell me that isn't exciting. You can't even tell how big they are. All you see is this thing disappear. couple big ones I saw that turned, they showed themselves. This one, all I saw was just disappear, set hook. No idea how big it is until you actually starts to pull and goes nuts like a bass. And there's a big hole in the brush right here that I haven't touched yet. Let's see. Somebody sitting in the brush? Huh? I got a brush bush monster? Where are you? Show me, boy. Show me. Wow. I'm gonna put it back here. Right back here where you guys are. There's sticks in the water. There's I saw one there. Nice grass right there. Grass, there's my bait. See how I dance it? Look at that little tail. Drives him just stupid. And then I stop. See how it still moves? I stop. Go down, swimming a bit. And just keep moving along the shoreline, looking for crappie. I see there should be some in here. I could be wrong. I'm not wrong. Look at the size of that crappie, dude. Look at the size of that crappie. I mean, this is a big, big crappie. Ready? Look at that crappie. How's that one, dudes? Right there. Look where he was. You talk about fighting? That thing fought like a largemouth. Look where he took it. Right in the brush, boys. Slab magnet, black slab, put the two together with a single pole. You are going to catch them. Just like you saw on the extreme crappie angler. This fish is going to go for pictures, and I'll show you. I will let her go. It's always another option to catch crappies. Pick up that single pole, go buy a few at your favorite store online, and you'll catch them just like that. Let's go. This is what we're doing. The brand new B&M tree thumper. We're not fishing near any trees, but it is like early August, 90 something degrees. We got the trout magnet, slab magnets, little jig heads, setback reels, with 8 pound test, and just dunking in five.
There we go, look at that.
Look at this thing, in 5 feet of water, and Joe's putting on a clinic.
Going in there again.
Hey.
And I mean, they're just smashing this right now, too.
Did you get him really low, Joe?
Right on the bottom. Right on the bottom there. I hit the bottom, lifted up just a little bit, and wham. Just tanked it.
So, you don't have to wait for spring. You don't have to wait for fall. Summertime, if you're patient. We came out here for an evening bite, and we're going to do that on topwater and jerkbaits and stuff like that. But right now, why waste our time? Why wait? You pick up the long pole. I've got the 12 footer, Joe's got the 10, and just going along, catching crappies. Well, he is anyway right now. But I missed a good one, dude. I saw him right up high.
Chased it all the way up, eh?
Right there.
There you go, you got him. Look at that.
Joe, isn't it incredible, this the single pole fishing?
Oh, it's unbelievable. Right? I mean, the action you get from this.
Wow. Come here, open your mouth. Look at that little plate right there. Little plate. Whoop, nothing near a bragging size, but in August, up here in Northern Ontario, tastes like crappie. Let's let them go. Ready? Go on. Basically, it's real simple, but you just got to have patience when you're doing this. Patience, because you got a long rod, you're going along. And a lot of times, I just put out enough line. Watch this. You saw it before. This is 12 foot, so I bring it up. Now that's about 12. So I got 24 feet now. So when I get a fish, I can just lean like this. And sometimes if he's real big, I'll have to get the net. But otherwise, you can lean back, swing him, the pendulum. When he's over the boat, let go, he drops in the boat. Once in a while, you get the vegetation. But no vegetation, no crappie.
Right.
Right on that dark edge. Oh my goodness, look at him.
Oh, that's a nice one again, eh? Hey. People jumping out of the water too, right?
Yeah. Look at this. Oh my goodness. Wow. Yep. What a plate.
Oh yeah, look at these things are just
dude. Crazy, eh? You got a good one, Joe.
Yep.
Just yep.
Oh, look at these fish, eh?
Oh yeah, man.
Just perfect crappie.
Mm-hmm.
The players for that one?
Let's see. Oh boy, yeah.
I'll get them for you.
Thanks. You know they're eating it hard in August.
Yep.
In 6 feet of water. Look at that. You can't beat that, eh?
Beautiful fish.
Yeah, man. Ready? Go on, boy.
Perfect.
There's the stuff right there that we're fishing. Look at it. Just some weird cabbagey. 5 feet of water, real nice and thick. Stuff that pike like, walleye like, smallmouth like, and obviously these crappies like. Little bait. Check my hook point. That's sharp. Right there. Let's do it. But we're still catching crappies.
Oh yeah. Like gold.
Yeah, man. Swing down.
Oh.
He's in the boat. We're getting a bunch of twins too, Billy. Look at that. Twin crappie. I'm going to throw that. Oh, you little bugger. Sharp, sharp little fins. Put it right by the boat here. Watch. Can I get one right here? It's incredible. When they stack up under certain things, a little bit of pads and grass, it's like they're right there. Like walleyes and smallmouth. They just gang up. And you find them, pulls down, and fish them.
Yep.
Look. Good just one?
Like that. Yep, decent fish too.
Oh my goodness. Decent? That's huge, that's a
nice
dude.
Slab, eh?
Look
at that thing. Just inhaled it too. Oh my God. Look at this. Swing, this is one Joe. Heck of a swing.
Swing.
And it's in. Look at that.
Oh my goodness, dude. Wow. You got it there, Joe. You got it.
Same thing. They're just taking right down too, eh?
It looks real, buddy.
Just loving that, eh?
Another fish to take home?
Throw that one in the box for sure. I mean, what a fish. Just thump.
You got him way out there too, and he just pulled.
I was swimming that back, yeah.
This is
fantastic, eh?
You feel like a kid when fishing crappies, eh?
Oh, yeah.
But just the way they eat it.
Yep. Whack.
Like that.
There you go, yeah.
Wow.
I mean, they're hitting it so fast, you don't even get time to set the hook.
Oh, my goodness. But it is that pendulum swing, too, yep. Right? I let it get down and then bring it slow.
There you go. Look at that.
Oh, my goodness me. Look at that.
Nice fish again, too, right?
Oh, my goodness, Joe.
Talk about fun or what?
Talk about fun. Yeah, man. And just figuring out how they want it, too, right? We slowed right down with them poles.
Yep.
Hooper's got it. I hear the splashing. You know what that means?
Yep.
Mr. Taylor has got another crappie.
It's a small version of yours, though, but I mean, wow. Like, look at the colors. Like, there's blue in the tail on these things, eh?
You know, it's a pretty good afternoon. We're just considering just throwing those back.
Oh, right? Yeah.
Look how round they are, too, here.
Just incredible.
Look at
right?
The fins. They look like those things you see in salt water, don't they? That's what gives them all that power when they're swimming, eh? Turning and stuff. Look at that, dude. Looks like it's painted. Man.
Perfect colors, eh?
Oh, I love crappies. Hey, yeah, man, you just make us so happy. Right, crappie? Hold on. But the patience you got to have.
Oh, yeah.
Drop it down. The rods are so sensitive, too. There's no way you missed that bite, eh?
Nope.
No way.
Oh, you feel everything with these rods, man.
Yeah.
So that's what makes this so fun, though.
You got it. So I'm going about every 10, 15 feet. I'm in 5.4 feet of water. All thick milfoil, coontail pads and stuff. And right there on the edges and stuff. Go 10, 15 feet, pulls down, just like we do in spring. Dissect and dominate. That's exactly what we're doing.
Where's the middle?
Oh, my. Right, right there, Joe.
Oh, there we go. Look at that. Yeah, right here. I put him down. There's a couple here. For sure. Look at this.
That's a good one you got, eh?
Decent fish, yeah.
I mean, the colors on these fish right now are just unbelievable in the summer, eh?
Mm-hmm. And that weed.
Yep. Just beautiful, decent fish. Great colors on them.
Look at this one, Joe.
Oh, another tank. Wow.
Hey. Look how they fight.
Fish almost holy. Jeez. Look at it.
And then swing.
Oh, yeah. Look at that, eh?
Wow. Who doesn't love crappie, Joe?
Oh.
He's got it again. Look at that. Look at that. Come on, man. Slab magnet. Do you have any slab magnets? I suggest you get some slab magnets as fast as you can. These little baits with that profile, look at that little tail. I'm barely moving it. Just think what the crappie think. They go nuts for it. Another one?
Yep, just a little guy.
Wow. Picture fish. Picture fish. We'll let you go. Don't worry, crappie. Single poling. Right here, Steve Dana designed this pole for B&M. He's down in Monroe, Louisiana, fishing Darbonne and those trees and cedar trees and all that different stuff. But what we're doing, fishing the edge of the weed line, just like for Canadian walleye here in Ontario. But it's crappies with the same techniques with these tree thumper by B&M. Thank you, Steve Dana, because we is catching some big black slabs.
There you go. There's a nice fish, too. Look at the size of that.
Just finished seeing.
Wow. Look at the colors on that fish.
Yeah, man.
What a tank.
Wow.
You cannot beat that anywhere.
What a feeling, dude. See why you sharp hooks? Right up through the nose. I got to show you this. There's the importance right there. There's the hook coming out right there. Wow, look at that fish was meant for TV. You know why? There's no way he's coming out of there. Look at that crappie, man. Think about that for a minute. Look at the size of that crappie. Summertime, August, single poling, Northern Ontario. You coming? We take some pictures. We respect the fishery. You know, we keep those 10 to 11s and 12s, but fish like that, they're priceless. Look at it. Big mouth. Whoa, sharp gills. Man. Respect the fishery. Catch them, kiss them, let them go. Keep enough for a meal so you can come back another day and catch some more. I'm going to keep moving, Joe. See, you put the poles on right away. 1-2 punch. Put the poles down. Fix it back up. And I got one on here. I call it gold dust. I'm not sure if it's even on the market yet. But Jeff, a crappie magnet, sent me some. He's like, I know you like that gold flake. And it's got chartreuse tail. Those crappies see it. They annihilate it right there. That's gold dust. Fix it up, catch some more. Look at that fighter.
Yep. Nice fish there, right?
Yeah, man. I'll come on this side of you. Look at that. Hey. Wow.
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
One, two, right?
Oh, tanks. Tank City, boy. Hey, crappie in August.
Whoop. There we go.
With the tree thumper by B&M. That black slab's there, eh?
Oh,
what do you think
that.
Of those? How thick and chunky. Oh, yeah,
nice
dude.
Nice fish, eh?
Great way to end our day, huh? Boy, look at that. We got a bunch like that. Let these go because they're going to produce more. But you want to catch them? Learn how to single pole, man. Put down the float. Pick up the single pole, 10 foot, 12 foot, hunt them down, stock them down, just like bass. You want to catch big crappies in summertime in Northern Ontario? That's what you got to do. Pick up the single pole, put down the float, focus, concentration, power poles, use all your tools, but especially by trout magnet, crappie magnet, the slab magnet, and B&M gets it done. Okay, this is a deal today, right there. By crappie magnet, the slab magnet. It's a thicker profile like a shad bait, okay? Flat top, little flat tail. And look at that. You barely got to move your arm. Showed you in the water. I barely shake my wrist. Get that tail just to kick. And I got it in the B&M. Sam Super Sensitive jig pole. 12-footer, two-piece. With the setback reel seat. A small little reel. You know what? That's not even a reel. It just holds the line. That's all I want. So pulling up line out. That's why the options are using different colors, man. I saw that fish come up. Oh God, look at that one. Look at this one, dude. Look at this one. That's what I'm talking about right there. Look at this tank. Oh boy, is he a netter? I think he is. Look at that. Come here, Carl, come here. Wow, look at this thing. Look at this thing. Wasn't sure about bringing the net. I'm gonna take a chance, and I think I got him good, but boy, oh boy. Don't take a chance on big crappies. Look at him. Look at him. That is a tank, dudes. Look where he got it. Look where he got it. That is a tank. I saw one just turning. With the glasses, even a muddy water. That's the deal. Right there. You think you see some big crappies in muddy water? Dude, that's a big crappie, boy. Look at the back on him. Look how thick that back is. Hey? Nice, beautiful, thick fish. Put you in there. You are a respect. I'll take some pictures with some of your girlfriends and boyfriends. And I'll let you go. Is that good? You know why? Because the thrill of seeing you come up and go, ooh, made it all worthwhile. Let's put him in here. Look at that, man. Look at that. That's when they say, that's a plateful. Look at that. Beautiful fish. Look how they extend their mouth, you know? I'm not stretching them, but they just come up, boom, sunk in that bait. Let me show you something about these crappy magnets. You know what? There's all different baits to use, okay? Yeah, people talk about sometimes spring and the water's cold and stuff like that, but the water's cold here. Bigger profile bait. I don't want to catch 7 and 10 inch crappies all day. I want to catch big crappies. That's got a little bit bigger body. What I'm seeing in the water here is like pin minnows, you know? They're about that long. Once in a while, I'm lifting this up. That's got the silver flash with the gold chartreuse. Resembles it perfectly. So you know they're just coming up. They think it's so real. They're not like attacking. They just come up and keep swimming. I wait till they close their mouth. Very important when you're single poling, not to get all crazy when you see the fish and stuff like that. Wait, these B&Ms right here, see down here? They've got that little, the blank through the handle. A little bit of cork there. So one of my fingers is always on the edge there, and I feel that. Plus I have my other hand out holding the line. So it's a combination of, I feel that, feel it here, feel it in my hand, and I see it. Those three things help you put those crappies in the boat when you're single poling, but wait till they close their mouth. Very similar to like frog fishing, buzz baits and stuff on the surface for largemouth. Wait till they close their mouth. They're not gonna spit it. Just wait that extra second, then set hook, then catch. Something about when you find crappie, they're not hard to catch, but it's just having the patience and the fortitude and the stubbornicity, I call it, of finding them. Because once you find them, it's incredible. Put the poles down, anchor down, and just wait. Single pole and going around, getting their attention, bringing it up, shake it, round, swim it, stop it. And it's just like they come out of the tree, they look, roll on it. But they don't come flying at it. They just slowly come up. You don't see them in that dirty water. You just see that last flash, or all you see is this little bait disappear. Any more crappies in the tree? Leave it alone for 10 minutes, come back, and hope that there's more there, more ready to eat. Pole's going down. Once you're stable, I let it settle. Pick my spot. How about right here? Oh my God! Ooh. Big, big crappie. Big, big crappie. Look at this one. Wow. Wow. Oh yeah. Major picture fish. And he is a battler. Half his tail's missing. He's got pike scars all through him. Look at this thing. Tell me he's not a battler. Look at, look. Half his tail got eaten off by a pike. And he still wanted the slab magnet. Don't worry, girl. Don't worry. I'll respect you. I'll take pictures with you. Look at her. Half her tail's gone. She's got scars up here. You think she got, maybe it could be a cormorant, but look at the size of that slab. That's probably, oh man, six, that's about 7 inches high. Nice and thick. take some pictures of you and put you back, okay? Oh yeah, wow, wow. Big fish, big fish. Okay, my two pulls for the day, real simple stuff, you know? The Sam Super Sensitive 12 footer, setback reel, a little reel at the back, you know? It's the BAN01. This holds a little bit of 6 pound gamma line, little slab magnet right there with the 1/8 ounce jig head. That's in the gold dust. And the other one, I'm gonna keep things real simple today, is the ultralight, 12 foot. Again, way back with the rear seat for the reel back here. And this one, orange, 1/8 ounce, orange or chartreuse. We're keeping things real simple. Back and forth with those colors, back and forth. I know that these fish are gonna eat one of these two colors. There's just any more crappies around in that shade line. Look at it. I tease them down there and then I bring them up. Tease them and then bring them up. All of a sudden they decide to see the minnow, in this case the slab magnet, and then they eat it. Be harder when the shape, when that sun goes away, it's harder. Should be some out here. So I shake that tail sometimes, get their attention, then I just hold it steady. A little flick of the tail. I'm doing is a little flick of the wrist. Swim it a bit. Watch this. Just swim it a little bit. Look how that looks like a minnow. It's over here. See it? One's gonna eat it. Well, watch this. One's gonna eat it. It's gonna come up. He's gonna get mad at it. He's gonna get mad at it. I don't know how much. There he goes. Look how black he is. Look at how black he is. Let's go this way. Oh, little crappie. Look how black he was. You know where he was hiding, huh? He was hiding in the tree. He's gonna come right towards you, fans. Whoa. Right towards you. Right towards you. When they get this dark, you know where they were hiding. Right in the thick of the tree. Again, we got some of those bigger ones. It's just a nice, beautiful, I'd say he's a male. Look how dark he is. Look how dark. I know. Thinner back. Let's let him go right here, huh? Let's let him go. Ready, crappie? Ready? Go on. Bye. It's so important when you're single pulling for crappie to be patient. You know, you go long, it's not like largemouth. You pull a big one off the dock and say, yes, what's next? And look ahead and stuff like that. With crappies, it's the one that's patient gets those big ones. Because I pulled off a good one, pulled off a few other ones over there, and then the big girl decided, or big boy, I'm gonna eat it. And what I just saw there that pulled me down, I pulled it off that deep edge from about 2 feet to 4. As soon as I pulled it off there, pulled a bit up and let it sit for a sec, big bowl. So you're patient, let them go back into the tree, but you know what? They want to eat. What I'm seeing in this little canal here is these little pin minnows about that long. So before they do their business and stuff, they're interested in eating. They see that little slab magnet, and man, oh man, do they want to eat it. Check the hook point. Let's drop it straight down. Let's see if we can catch this fish right here, right now. Man, oh, I love seeing them. Love it. Where'd you go, big boy? Wow. That's as cool gets, man. Seeing them do that. Seeing them just roll on it. I thought he had it. Bait disappeared. There's another one. Like a tail walker. Ready? Here comes a swing. Ooh, another nice Beautiful crappie. Look at that. Beautiful crappies. Beautiful crappies. Beautiful crappies. They seem like the gold dust. Look at that. He ain't big as some of those other ones, but boy, he ain't as big as one I just saw back there. But that's an eater. Say, what's an eater? Well, you know what? If I get a decent fillet off that right there, we're going to have some crappies for dinner. It's so exciting. You can tell by my heartbeat, the adrenaline, you know, the speech. But I mean, when you're just doing that, you go, it's a sense of accomplishment, figuring it out, finding them. But like I said before, I'll say it again, there's so many different tools, from the motor guide at the front, the Garmin helping me find the water temperature, where it's warmer in these little cuts and canals, closer to the shorelines and things, and the shorelines just didn't have it. Nice wood and brush and stuff, no fish. They wanted those little cuts and stuff, the water went up to about 54 degrees. But the little slab magnet on the 12 footer, you got the whole chain. I'm constantly checking the hook points all the time. The gauge, when you set hook, it opens up the little fine wire hook once in a while. You just push it back down again with the pliers, checking that line. It goes down, those fish are rubbing against branches and brush and stuff, and you're fishing some nasty things. But putting all those little pieces together in the chain, and what's the result? Catching those big fat slabs. ¶¶